Hi lovely viewers, it's me again, your one and only Mutati Mpundu. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time on my channel, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel by hitting the red subscribe button down below and turn the bell icon to join the notification squad. Don't forget to like, share and leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this video in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you lovely viewers.
Hello, bless you, good morning. God bless you. Good morning. I can see. Let me know where you're watching me from. If you can hear me loud and clear, let me know that, Prophet. I can hear you. I want to dive into something that I've not wanted to dive into, but because of the many questions I've been receiving, the many messages I've been receiving, so I want to dive in so that a certain level of truth can be heard, a certain level of truth can be understood. Let me know where you're watching me from. People are watching me from Livingston. Others are watching me from Mukushi. Others are watching me from Zambia. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. God bless you. A lot of people have been asking me a lot of questions after the death of Prophet Edgar. And I want to quickly give you a lot of insight. And before I give you this insight, I want to tell you that Prophet Edgar, the man of faith, was a man of God. I want to quickly tell you that Prophet Edgar, the man of faith, was a man of God. Now, there is a controversial story going around that Siawan killed the man of faith, Prophet Edgar. Before Edgar contacted Siawan, or got in any connection with Siawan, he was a preacher of the gospel, a man of God, called by God. I'm going to tell you what happened before Edgar contacted Siawan, and after Edgar contacted Siawan, and after he left him. 3 weeks before, between 2 weeks and 3 weeks before Prophet Edgar died, he came to meet me one-on-one. Like I said in my past video, I said I knew this young man and I knew him heart to heart. Even after Prophet Edgar died, most of his friends from Kafue who were prophets also came to meet me one-on-one, and they shared quite a lot of things with me. As you are very much aware, a lot of prophets come to our ministry to seek counsel. A lot of prophets come to me to for impartation and a lot of things. So I didn't want to talk about the issue of Prophet Edgar until I saw that this issue has gone out of hand. I can see the man of God, Prophet Benjamin, watching. God bless you. Now, Edgar was a young man who was doing ministry, and things became a little bit hard for him. He was doing ministry and he wasn't doing very, very well. So he decided to seek impartation. When he decided to seek impartation, that was the time that he went and had an encounter with Siawan, whom I know personally, that is a witch. And nobody can convince me that Seer One is not a witch. So when Edgar met with Seer One, spoke with Seer One, Seer One promised Edgar riches. Seer One promised Edgar that Edgar was going to become very, very rich. Unfortunately, Edgar did not become rich. I want you to follow me very, very closely, because there are a lot of lies that have been spoken about the young man Edgar, and we have to set the record straight. Seer One promised Edgar that Edgar will become rich. Seer One promised Edgar that Edgar will have a massive ministry. Those of you that stay in Kafue know that Edgar never had a massive ministry. Those of you who stay in Kafue will bear witness that Edgar was never rich. The only property that Edgar bought after having connection with Seer One was a second-hand Alteza vehicle. That was the car that Edgar bought after having in contact with Seer One, a second-hand Alteza vehicle. Now, after Edgar bought that second-hand Alteza vehicle, because Edgar had contaminated his anointing, because Edgar had contaminated the call of God upon his life, he did not have peace. He did not have peace within his spirit. And Seer One started extorting money from Edgar, telling him that he was going to go to a different level and a different dimension. By that time, Edgar started having even trips out of the country. Now, because Edgar was being tormented by the calling of God upon his life, Edgar decided by himself. Nobody forced Edgar to disconnect from Seer One. Edgar had a calling of God upon his life, and he understood that my connection with Seer One is not of God. So Prophet Edgar decided to disconnect from Seer One, who is a witch. He decided to disconnect because he understood that God had called him. When Edgar decided to disconnect from Seer One started to threaten Edgar's life. He started to threaten him, and he said that because he has disconnected from him, he was going to kill him. Remember, the Bible says the devil comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. John 10, verse number 10. The devil comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. So when Prophet Edgar decided to disconnect from Seer One, of course, Seer One has got diabolical powers. He has diabolical means. He started to torment Prophet Edgar spiritually. The young man Edgar could see anointed Andrew in his dream. But I want you to look at this very critically, because it's very important. Seer One claimed that Edgar once upon a time had a big church. If you stay in Kafue, you can bear witness that Edgar never had even up to 50 members. If you stay in Kafue, you know that Prophet Edgar never had up to 50 members. So he started to torment the young man. He started to appear in his dreams. 3 weeks before Prophet Edgar died, Edgar came and met me one-on-one. And I spoke to Prophet Edgar and assured him that there is only one God and there is only one power. There is only one God and there is only one power. And that is Jesus Christ. And I encouraged him by the word of the Lord. And I said to him that we were going to pray and we were going to take a fast. Now, what killed Prophet Edgar? What killed Prophet Edgar is lack of courage to stand against the devil. That is what killed Prophet Edgar. Prophet Edgar failed to stand against the devices of the enemy. You see, his mind was so manipulated that they were going to kill his family. His mind was so manipulated that they were going to kill his son. So because of how they manipulated his mind and how they manipulated his spirit, the young man was afraid. And remember, the Bible says in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 7, "For God has not given you the spirit to fear, but the spirit of power, the spirit of love, and a sound mind." The moment Edgar gave Seer 1 access to his life, he became afraid. And whenever you become afraid, you are doomed. You will die. So because of how he was being tormented, Prophet Edgar was being told that we are going to use your son for sacrifice. And the young man could not bear that they are going to use his son because of the many manifestations that he saw. Number one, I want you to get this very clearly. They never gave him wealth. They never gave him anything. All they did was to torment him. Now, listen to me. Another young man from Chipata called me recently that had contacted Siawan. He was telling me of how they were tormenting him. Siawan should not lie. He should not lie that he gave Edgar anything. Edgar, despite him committing suicide, Edgar was a man of God. If Edgar was not a man of God, he would have given his son or his wife for sacrifice. But because he feared God and because he loved God, but he did not have the courage that some of us have to encounter these devils, to encounter these powers and defeat them. I happen to be one of the men of God that have talked about Seer 1 for a very long time, and I'm still alive. I happen to be one of the men of God that have disconnected from him, and I'm still alive. I want to challenge, the reason why I'm doing this video is because of a lot of Zambian young prophets have connected to this guy, and they are afraid. They have connected to this guy and they are afraid. They have connected to this guy and they are afraid that the moment they will disconnect from him, they will die. I am here to encourage you. There is only one God and there is only one power. And Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, he is able to deliver you. Do not be afraid to disconnect from occultism. Do not be afraid of disconnecting from witchcraft. Do not be afraid of disconnecting from Satanism. One of the reasons why Seer 1 made that post is not because of Edgar. One of the reasons why Seer 1 made that post is because he wants to keep young men of God who have connected to him in bondage. He wants to keep them in captivity. Listen to me and listen to me very well. If you are watching me and you have connected to diabolical powers, God can deliver you. If you are watching me and you have connected to the pit of hell, God can deliver you. Look at the life of the young man. Look at the life of a young man, Prophet Edgar. Seer 1 is now lying that he gave him wealth when Edgar was never rich. Seer 1 is now lying that Edgar had a big ministry when Edgar never had a big ministry. He is lying to you. He's deceiving you. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to let you know, if you have, there is also a young woman that contacted me and said, Prophet, this man is threatening me. There is no way a prophet of God will threaten you. There is no way a prophet of God will begin to manipulate you. The God we serve is not a manipulator. Edgar died a man of God. Edgar died because he lacked courage to stand on and rebuke the devil. You see, when the devil comes into your mind, he comes into your spirit, he torments your mind, he torments your spirit, he makes you understand that there is nothing you can do. That is what the devil does. But I'm here to tell you, there is something that you can do to that devil. You can rebuke that devil and the devil will flee. You see, an idle mind is the devil's workshop. When you allow the devil into your life, you can rebuke him out of your life. It is a misconception for you to believe and think that when you disconnect from that devil, you will be defeated. No. How many years has it been since Seer 1 prophesied that I was going to die? How many years has it been? I'm still alive. I am one of, if not the only man of God that has been able to stand against it, and I'm still standing. So if you're a young man of God, and you have collected anything from him, and you are afraid of giving away what you have collected because he is going to kill you, is a liar. Edgar was a man of God. Ask people in Kafue, those of you that know people in Kafue, Edgar was not rich. Ask people in Kafue, Edgar was not rich. The young man was struggling in ministry, but Seer 1 managed to manipulate him. That's what he does to many young men of God. He manages to manipulate them so that he can steal away their glory, so that he can steal away their star. That is what he did to Edgar. He stole his star. He manipulated his destiny and later started asking for sacrifices. If Edgar was not a man of God, Edgar would have given his family for sacrifices. But I still stand as a prophet, even in death, to defend that young man. Do not bring his legacy to disrepute. Yes, at one point in his life, he connected to Seer 1. But for the very fact that he disconnected from him, we must clap for him. He is truly a man of God. Many men of God that are watching me right now secretly have connected to altars they are not supposed to connect to. But just because Edgar has died, we want to come out and begin to preach as if Edgar was wicked. No, the young man was not wicked. The young man was asked by Seer 1 to give his son for sacrifice, and the young man could not do it. That is who Edgar was. Edgar feared God. Edgar loved God. We will not allow our young men in ministry to die in silence. There is another young man who is a friend of Edgar who came to meet me immediately after Edgar died and showed me proof of messages, how Seer 1 has been manipulating them. How Seer 1 has been manipulating these young men of God into giving things their lives for sacrifice. No, the devil comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But I have come so that you may have life and have it more in abundance. Seer 1 never gave Edgar wealth. He never gave Edgar wealth. He never gave Edgar riches. He never gave Edgar anything. He wanted to collect from Edgar. He wanted to collect from Edgar. He wanted to be collecting from Edgar. And we will not stand as men of God. The only unfortunate thing that happened to Edgar was for Edgar to be afraid. Fear is a spirit. The moment Edgar became afraid, that is the moment that he became defeated. Otherwise, Edgar was defeating Seer 1. He was defeating him, but he became afraid. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you that fear is the enemy of your progress. Fear is the enemy to your results. Fear is the enemy. Fear is the enemy. I'm telling you, the only enemy that Edgar had was fear. It is better It is better. I still repeat this. It is better. It is better to be poor than to follow Seer. It is unfortunate. Many young men are coming to me in silent. I cannot expose them. I cannot be saying, this is what this young man told me. This is what this young man told me. Many young men are coming and they are saying what happened to them and how they got manipulated on how they got initiated. Many young men in ministry are getting initiated because when they contact a certain man of God, he will tell them, if you tell anybody, you're going to die. That is how they are getting initiated. If you tell anybody, this and this is going to happen to you. So they are living in fear. They are failing to disconnect because of what the person told them. This is what is happening right now. It is not only happening in Zambia. It is not only happening in Africa. It is happening around the world. Edgar contacted Seer and disconnected from him. But during the time that Edgar was with Seer, Edgar was not rich. Edgar was not rich. Anybody in Kafue knows that Edgar never amassed wealth. And that is to tell you that the devil is a liar. The devil will promise you heaven and earth, but the devil is a liar. The devil will promise you all kinds of things, but the devil is a liar. If you are watching me right now and you are a prophet and you are afraid to come out of certain things because of what they told you, I'm opening my hands to you. Come. God will help you. I'm still alive. I'm not dead. I'm still alive. I'm still alive. I'm not dead. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you are watching me and you are a prophet, or you are not even a prophet, you have engaged yourself into occultism. You have engaged yourself into witchcraft. You have engaged yourself into satanism. And you are tired of the devices of the enemy and you want to come out. The devil is a liar. You will not die. You can only die if you allow yourself to die. You can only die if you allow yourself to die. You can only die if you allow yourself to die. The devil is a liar. He comes to steal. He comes to kill. He comes to destroy. But Jesus came so that you may have life and have it in him. I am helping a lot of prophets. Right now, I want even to get a house that I'm going to be calling a mission house, where I'm going to be helping men of God that are stranded, men of God that don't have where to sleep. I'm getting a mission house that I'm going to furnish. I'm going to give it the best life that it deserves. I'm going to do a lot of things for men of God. So if you are a man of God and you are saying, man of God, prophecy and Genesis, I went somewhere and they told me to do 1, 2, 3, 4. And then my life is messed up. Because Edgar's life was going good until he met Anointed Andrew. Edgar's life was moving very well until he met Seer. When he met Seer, things became, you know, you cannot say that you now have power when all you can buy is an old car. You cannot say I've now become rich when all you can buy is an old car. Look at this. If Seer is now boasting that he made Edgar rich, an old Alteza is being rich. An old Alteza, second hand Alteza. You are saying you are now rich because of a second hand Alteza. The last time I met Prophet Edgar, he was not even using a very big phone. He was using a very, very small Android phone. And he has the audacity to claim that he made him rich. What kind of rich is that? The blessing that you can only get is the blessing of the Lord. Because the blessing of the Lord maketh one to be rich and addeth no sorrow. The blessing of the Lord. If you are a man of God or you are a believer, what you need is the blessing of the Lord. So those of you that are asking me left, right, and center, Papa, What is happening? Did Seer 1 kill Edgar? Edgar died because he was just afraid. Edgar was just psychologically defeated. If the devil had power, the devil would have killed his parents. The devil would have killed his wife. The devil would have killed his son. But they manipulated his mind. They manipulated his spirit. That's what they do. They manipulated. How many young men are going to die because of this disconnection? What kind of wealth is that? What kind of wealth? What kind of wealth is that? That you acquire wealth and afterwards the wealth will get away. No. Those of you that are telling me that I must be afraid of Seer 1, I've been fighting Seer 1 from 2015 and I'm still alive. So your advice doesn't really add any value. It doesn't really add any weight. Because this is an enemy I understand. This is an enemy I know. This is an enemy I know his strength. This is an enemy I know. This enemy can never defeat me spiritually. This is an enemy I know. So, ladies and gentlemen, Prophet Edgar, may his soul rest in peace. Yes, the young man gave up the ghost. He was afraid. He was afraid. He was defeated through fear. But we are not defeated. We are still alive. And we are still living. So you want to put his name in disrepute? You want to crush his legacy? Don't crush the young man's legacy. Don't crush the young man's legacy. Everybody knows that I help a lot of men of God. I help a lot of men of God. I wish Prophet Edgar listened to what I told him. I said to him, do not be afraid. Prophet Edgar did not kill himself because of renters. Prophet Edgar killed himself because he was afraid. It wasn't because of renters. Prophet Edgar didn't kill himself because of money. Because the renters for Prophet Edgar was about between 2.5 and 3.5. So he didn't kill himself because of renters. He killed himself because he was afraid. So do not be afraid of the terror by night. Do not be afraid of the arrow that flies by day. With your eyes shall you behold and see the reward of the wicked. Sometimes, let me just tell you this. Sometimes the enemy can give you certain things. But sometimes those things that he gives you are there to entice you. They are there to entice you. They are there to entice you. Do not allow the enemy to entice you. Do not allow the enemy to make you feel like God is not answering your prayer. God is a wonder-working power. God is a wonder-working power. Those of you that are men of God, those of you that are men of God and you are watching this video, stay strong in the Lord. My encouragement, you are a man of God. Ministry is hard. Ministry is not easy. Sometimes people insult us even when we are helping them. People insult us even when we are helping them. But ministry is not easy. So if you are a man of God, I want to encourage you. Be strong in the Lord. Do not be strong in people. Be strong in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord. Be strong. You are a man of God. You are a prophet. You are an evangelist. Be strong in the Lord. And I pray for you. May God give you divine helpers. May God give you divine helpers. May God give you people strategically that will help you. People strategically that will stand with you. People that will stand a test of time with you. Ministry is not easy, but God called you because there is a greater assignment for you. Ministry can be tough, but God called you. Remember the calling of God. The calling of God is upon you. Young lady, young man, the calling of God is upon you. Do not allow the enemy to defeat you. Do not allow the enemy to remove or dilute the calling of God upon your life. You are highly anointed by God. You are highly blessed by God. You are highly lifted by God. The God that called you will sustain you in ministry. The God that called you will lift you in ministry. The God that called you will give you financial breakthrough in ministry. You are a woman of God. You are a man of God. I prophesy to you as a prophet. Look at how God has blessed me. Look at how God has lifted me. God will lift you. I'm telling you. The lifting does not come from the east. The lifting does not come from the west. The lifting comes from the Lord. We understand that the greatest anointing that you can carry is that which is imparted on him. But listen to me, it is not everywhere where you can get impartation. There are certain people, when you mix your anointing with them, you will begin to struggle. I prophesy as a prophet, wherever it is that you are hearing the sound of a voice, I prophesy to you, you are going to make it. And I come against the spirit of suicide. There are many of you who are watching me right now. Because of fear, you want to give up the ghost. Because of fear, you want to kill yourself. My name is Prophet Ian Genesis. And I am the man that is carrying the Genesis mandate, demonstrating the God of the beginning in the night. And I prophesy to you, you are not going to die. You are going to be lifted by Yahweh. The hand of God is going to lift you. The anointing of God is going to support you. Wherever it is that you are, I decree and I declare, let there be financial lifting over your life. Let there be business lifting over your life. Listen to me, the devil is a liar. Wherever it is that you are, the devil is a liar. And in this season and in this time, the devil will be defeated. Listen to me and listen to me very well. These are the words and the oracles of the prophet. By a prophet, Israel was preserved. By a prophet, they were sustained. I speak as a prophet. Let there be sustenance upon your life. I know I'm speaking even to one young man. I'm speaking to one young woman who is a prophet of God, who is a prophet of Jehovah, who is a man of God. You are talking to me. I went to a native doctor, and the native doctor told me 1, 2, 3. I want to speak to you. You are not going to die. The anointing of God, there is restoration upon your life. And I want to invite you. I want to encourage you that if you need somebody to talk to, come. Let me talk to you. Let me speak to you. Let us pray. Let us see if God will not lift you up. I know there is a God that lifts up men. I know there is a God that sets up people and is going to set you up. I know there are people who are tempted right now to do all kinds of things they want to do. But I want to encourage you, by the oracles of Jehovah, as a prophet of God, wherever it is that you are, the Lord will give you strength. 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 The enemy can only kill you if you give him access to your soul. The enemy can only kill you if you give him access to your life. Your life is blood washed. You are Holy Ghost filled. You are a child of destiny. I want to speak to 29 people hearing the sound of my voice. God is telling me he is going to raise 29 prophets. 29 prophets. 29 prophetess. Hear me and hear me well. The fresh anointing is coming upon you. Fresh anointing. There is a God we serve. He's a lifter of men. He is the lifter of men. He is going to lift you up. The God we serve is a lifter of men. He is going to lift you up. Sometimes, ladies and gentlemen, the devil will tell you that I will give you 50 million. That I will give you 50 million. But when he gives you that 50 million, what will he ask from you? He may ask for your father. He may ask for your mother. It is better to be poor than to sacrifice a fellow human being to be rich. Listen, sometimes the devil can tell you that I'm going to give you a car. But after the devil gives you a car, he will ask you for something else. He will ask for your womb. So do not be deceived by the devil. The devil is a deceiver. He is a liar. The devil can never be true. The truth cannot come out of him. It cannot. I'm telling you, it cannot. I know there are people whom I say these people are not gullible. I'm not saying these people are gullible. I'm saying there are people who are blind, who believe that they can go to the devil and ask something from the devil without the devil asking for something in return. I know you are desperate, but I know there is a God and he's a lifter of men. Listen to me. There are people who are watching me. You are so desperate right now. You are desperately in need of help. You are desperate in need of God to do something in your life. But I want to tell you and I want to encourage you. There is a God we serve. He is the lifter of men. His name is Jehovah Shammah. His name is Jehovah Nissi. And he is the lifter of men. He is the lifter of men. There is a God we serve, he's the lifter of men, and he's going to lift you up. There is a God we serve, he is the lifter of men. Do not worry about what you are going through. I know times are hard. There are people who are watching me and I say, but man of God, the reason why we go to these people is because times are hard. The reason why we consult these people is because I know that times are hard. But when the devil comes like a flood, the Lord will lift a standard. The Lord will lift a standard. The Lord will lift a standard. I know things are hard. Sister, I know things are hard, but you're going to witness God in the land of the living. I'm telling you, you are going to witness God in the land of the living. I know there's someone that is watching me and saying, man of God, you don't understand. My business is not doing well. That is why I want to even consult Siawan. Yes, I know your business is not fine, but I know there is a God that is a lifter of men. I know there is a God that is a lifter of men. I know there is a God, that there is a lifter. Even right now, there are people who are fighting with me on social media right now. I'm telling you, I know there are people. It's not that they are fighting with me because they want to fight with me. Some of them, they collected something right now. And they can't see themselves taking away what they collected. That is why some of them are fighting me, even on social media. But I know there is a God that is a lifter of men, and God is about to lift you. And if there is someone right now that is saying, man of God, truly, I'm gonna put our office number on this video right now, and I want you to contact us. If you really need help, you went somewhere and you collected something, I want you to text our number. I'm gonna see you, I'm gonna talk to you. Or you can go to our inbox, inbox me and say, Prophet, I need your help. I went somewhere, I collected something, and I want to release it. I'm going to pray for secretly. Listen, I'm not going to bring you in public and say this person collected this. No, secretly you can come. Talk to me secretly. Say, Prophet, this is what I collected. This is what I did. How can you help me? I'm going to help you. I'm going to pray for you, and I'm going to give you spiritual directions by God so that your life will be the same. Your life will move to the next level. Ladies and gentlemen, these are not times to be very, very ignorant of the devices of the enemy. These are not times to be ignorant of the devices of the crafty. The enemy comes to kill. The enemy comes to steal. The enemy comes to destroy, but God has come so that you may have life and have it in abundance. Ladies and gentlemen, someone is saying that I feel for your wife. I just bought my wife a BMW for Christmas, so there is nothing to feel for my wife. She's very happy, by the way. So those of you, listen, sometimes I wonder why people believe that it is only the devil that can bless. God can bless. I'm telling you, God can bless. I've seen the blessing of God. So there is no need for you to feel for my wife. My wife is living her best life. Her best life, I'm telling you. She's living her best life. But I'm feeling for you that want to support wickedness. I'm feeling for you that want to support witchcraft instead of supporting God. So if you are a young man, you are a young woman, even if you never collected anything and you need help, you know that things are hard, you are almost giving up and you need help, please go to our inbox, inbox me. Put, as someone is saying, is this live? Yes, I'm live. I'm live. As I'm speaking now, I'm live. It's not a recording. I'm live. I'm reading your comments. I can see Joshua saying, help, help Muzo. Yeah. Anybody that needs help, please, do not hesitate. Come to the office. We will help you. We will pray for you. Sometimes people, they believe that help is financial. No, help may not be financial. To pray for someone, to pray and impart the grace of God for their life is help. Some people, when they come, they come because all they need is financial. Sometimes what you need is not financial help. What you need is the anointing. Listen, I want you to be very clear with this. Whenever you go and meet a man of God, do not be very keen in financial help, because finances may end, but an anointing will not end. So anytime you go and meet a man of God, look for the anointing that is behind him. I want to make this very clear, because many people, they just say, no, man of God, help me, help me. Listen, if what you need is me to give you 100 kwacha, then you don't need help. What you need is the anointing that backs the anointing. What you need is the anointing. Let me repeat what I'm saying. What you need is the anointing that backs the anointing. Because when you receive the anointing, you will not beg anymore. When you receive the anointing, you will not look for someone to help you the next day. That is why Jesus said, I will make you. I will make you. I will make you. I will make you. So what you need is the anointing. That's what you need. The anointing of God. It will make you. You see, the anointing can change people's lives. The anointing can change people. I'm telling you, the anointing can change people's lives. So wherever it is that you are, someone is saying, Prophet, help me, my family. There is confusion. Come. Come. God will help you. God will help you. God will help you. The devil is there to deceive you, but God will help you. Remember, my name is Prophet Ian Genesis, and I am the man that is carrying the Genesis mandate. And without fear of contradiction, I tell you, you are blessed in Jesus' mighty name, the Son of the Living God. Shalom for now.
Alright, that's all right for you today, lovely viewers. If you did enjoy the video, please don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about the video you just watched in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you, lovely viewers. Once again, I go by the name of Mutati Mpundu. I love you, peace. I gotta go.